Good evening, everybody. Today I will be presenting one small case of 14 patients in the study conducted in Indraprastha Apollo Hospital, New Delhi. This is study mainly focused on profile of central venous stenosis in hemodialysis patients and efficacy of percutaneous intervention in these patients. The chronic kidney disease is one of the leading cause of death and morbidity across the globe. Over 2 million people now receive renal replacement therapy to sustain life worldwide, and this likely represents less than 10% of those who need it. And patients on maintenance hemodialysis frequently develop venous obstruction in central veins. There are multiple risk factors, both medical and risk factors related to dialysis, like multiple central venous catheter placements, longer dwell times, and longer duration on dialysis. Medical complications are diabetes, dyslipidemia, and vascular diseases. The main aim of the study is to study the profile of central venous obstruction in hemodialysis patients and the efficacy of PCI. And we follow up these patients immediately after intervention at 3 months and at 6 months. And we monitor the dialysis adequacy and the flows by Doppler studies. And this is a prospective observational hospital-based study. It includes 14 patients who present to us with vascular axis abnormalities, and it underwent from June 2015 to December 2016. Central venous stenosis diagnosed based upon the clinical presentation, examination, and non-invasive studies like Doppler CT angiography and invasive studies like angiography. And we did the interventions like angioplasty and stenting in critical stenotic lesions, and we follow up these patients at 3 months and 6 months. And the coming to the characteristics of population, the mean age of these patients about 53 years, and duration of CKD mainly about 4 years, and dialysis duration about 2.9 years mean. The commonest comorbidities are hypertension in 89% of cases, diabetes in 44% of cases. Most of these patients presents with prolonged bleeding and prolonged bleeding from needle sites and increased venous pressure during dialysis. Other features like dialysis dysfunction in 55% of cases, arm swelling in 30%, arm, neck, and chest swelling in 15% of cases. And the most common site of involvement is left subclavian vein, followed by left innominate vein. In 6 patients, left subclavian vein stenosis occurs. And the least common is left subclavian, or right subclavian, sorry. And the site of previous cannulation, there is history of previous cannulation in IJV, either left or right in 12 patients, femoral in 1 patient, and there is no previous cannulation in 1 patient. And we did the intervention based upon the angiographic findings. We tried to dilate these stenosis for 5 minutes with balloon angioplasty, and we will wait for 5 minutes. If there is a recoiling lesion, then we did stenting. In 4 patients, we did angioplasty only, and in 8 patients we did angioplasty plus stenting, and in one patient there is a difficulty for stenting, so we did AV fistula closure to relieve symptoms, and in one patient we didn't did any intervention due to financial restraints. And coming to the success rate, in angioplasty cases, there is 100% success. In stenting, only 7 cases were succeeded. And complications are minor. There are 3 cases of dissection, but there are linear type dissections. We managed with conservatively. Upon follow-up, in patients with only PTA, 3 months patency rate was 75%, and 6 months patency rate was 50%. PTA with stenting, it is 100% 3 months patency rate, 6 months patency rate was 75%. Coming to the discussion, And some studies like Genome et al. Reported central venous obstruction as most common complication, occurs in 53% of cases, individually in left subclavian in 22%. The success rate is comparable with other studies. Coming to patency rate, Becken et al. In 2007 has reported a patency rate of 58% at 3 months, 6 months 45%. The complications were minor in Dong et al. Study, that is only 0.3%, but in our study there are more complications because we used high pressure balloon. And this is the bibliography. And concluding my study, multiple catheterization for dialysis is an important risk factor for central venous obstruction in hemodialysis patient. Upper limb veins are almost exclusively involved in hemodialysis access related stenosis. And endovascular treatment like PTA and PTA stenting is safe and with lower rates of technical failure. Stenting has definite advantage over angioplasty in terms of vessel patency, but this difference is not significant. The main drawbacks of the study are it includes small number of patients, non-randomized, and we did only 6 months of follow-up. Thank you.